Good afternoon. She World News is on the steps of City Hall with Councilman David Greenfield. Just wrapped up a press conference, which very well may turn into national news across the United States of America. Tell us what went on by the press conference and what is this new piece of legislation that you just introduced?
You know, I'm introducing new legislation that would ban effectively naked body scanners from our airports. This is a scanner that is not proven to actually work and may in fact actually harm the physical well-being of New Yorkers. In fact, the Israelis, who of course everybody knows Ben Gurion Airport in Israel is the most secure and the top terrorist target in the world, their former head of security has publicly said that these naked body scanners do not work and that he himself could get through enough explosives to take down a jumbo jet. So I think it's clear that these scanners are not effective, not to mention, quite frankly, for our community, they're not very tsnius. I mean, just think about what's happening in our community. You know, we have a very unique community where our entire lives, you know, we live in modesty, and now, the next time you go to Florida, or to Eretz Yisrael, or to you visit your relative in Chicago or Los Angeles, they want to force you to go through a machine that literally has the technology to show your naked body to a TSA employee. It's an outrage, it's unacceptable, it's ineffectual, and that's why I've introduced legislation with the support of many of my colleagues in the City Council to ban these naked body scanners from the entire New York City, including New York's airports.
When you say the entire New York City, is there any word of implementing these naked body scanners in, for example, walking into City Hall or any other major building in New York City that belongs to the city?
Well, that's an excellent point. That's, in fact, why we're doing the entire city ban. In other cities throughout the country, including Orlando, Florida, they use these in municipal buildings. And we actually discovered recently that in Orlando, Florida, they were keeping these images. And there are 35,000 naked images of people who are walking into a courthouse in Orlando. Can you imagine you're walking into a courthouse, they take a naked image of you and they keep it? So this legislation would prevent this kind of intrusive and invasive technology from going into our government buildings, and it would also get them out of LaGuardia and JFK International Airports. Remember, once again, even according to Israel's top security experts, this does not work. So the obvious question is, well, if it doesn't work, then why are we using it? The answer is that sadly, as many people know who've interacted with the TSA is incompetent. So they need to pretend like they have technology that works, but it doesn't work. Even according to the GAO, which is the Government Accountability Office, they did research on this and they found that just a few days after the attempted underwear bombing last year over Detroit, two very powerful companies that have very powerful lobbies, one of whom is Michael Chertoff, the former director of Homeland Security, the other of whom is Al D'Amato, they quickly got $175 million contracts apiece to rush these unproven technologies. And when they did the review, they discovered that this technology would probably not have stopped the underwear bomb.
Well, this law that you're trying to implement, will this actually work? Will it get passed in the airport? So how does that work? Does New York City control the airports? Do they own the airports? How does that work?
Well, in fact, technically, the City of New York owns the airports, and the Port Authority leases and operates the airports. And so, therefore, we believe that we have the ability to ban these because these are buildings in New York City. And in fact, I spoke to the Port Authority yesterday. I've actually encouraged them to do what a major international airport did today in Florida, which is to opt out of TSA security and pick an alternative, competent security provider.
Last question, Councilman Greenfield. Do you have any feeling or any reason to believe that the United States government, the federal government, will tell the City of New York or this airport in Orlando, just like we control the FAA or the NTSB, we will make the rules for security in the airports, even if the airport is on New York City soil, we will make the security procedures. It's our policy. We'll set down the law, and they will override you. Is that possible?
We don't think they could override us, actually. It's a terrific question. And, you know, all their power derives from laws. And the law that created this post-9/11 structure, right, basically has given the authority to the local airports to opt out. And we also believe that this law allows cities to ban these specific practices. Remember, we're not saying no security in airports. Obviously, if we said we don't want any security, they could come in and say you need some security. We're saying we don't want security that doesn't work, that's unproven, that literally shows your naked figure to an unknown TSA underqualified employee. And finally, and this everybody knows, is very dangerous, right? You know, Baruch Hashem, I've been to the hospital a few times for broken bones. When I've taken x-rays, every time they put a piece of equipment over you to protect your most sensitive body parts. Not so when you're walking through this x-ray machine in the airport. It could be very harmful. For all those reasons, we believe that we have the legal authority and ability to pass a law that would stop this in New York City and hopefully lead the way throughout the United States.
Thank you so much, Councilman Greenfield. Good luck.
Thank you, Yeshiva Wall. TSA first introduced this technology. What they did was they introduced it to several of their screeners. And in order to show how the technology works, one of the screeners actually walked through. His colleagues, apparently, when they saw his entire body, they made fun, shall we say, of his personal private parts. In return, this professional TSA screener beat his colleague and was actually arrested for assault. These are the professionals, okay, who are actually screening you and me, and even they are embarrassed to go through this machine.